Now for Makar Rashi people, the eclipse is happening in the 6th house. Rahu is bad, Jupiter is bad, Saturn is not very supportive. Overall, it doesn't paint a very great picture. One thing that I feel will happen to Makar Rashi people would be that their wisdom would be at an all-time low. So this is the time when usually people end up making very stupid mistakes, silly stupid mistakes. So make sure that you are a little careful and make sure that your wisdom doesn't put you in a bad state. Especially in workplace situations, I think you need to be extra cautious, because you might end up making unnecessary mistakes, unnecessary silly mistakes. You're also prone to getting poisoned, or it could even be some sort of a bacterial infection. So be careful in terms of what you consume. Make sure the water that you take is boiled, is filtered. You don't just go and drink water from any tap or any source. Makar Rashi people also have a high chance of getting cheated in the name of spirituality. So be careful. Don't fall prey for the so-called spiritual gurus. Some people might be genuine, but most of them here are nowadays quacks. So be careful. Don't get cheated by them. You are very susceptible at this point of time. So don't get cheated by them. From a remedial perspective, here's what I'm asking you to do. During the eclipse, I want you to chant Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. The Ganesha Japam, I want you to do it as many times as possible, followed by one of the two mantras. It can either be Om Namo Narayanaya, or you can do Om Namah Shivaya. Now do this 108 times, multiples of 108 times. Do it as many times as possible, but multiples of 108 times. When you chant Om Namo Narayanaya, do it with a Tulsi, use a Tulsi Mala. When you do Om Namah Shivaya, use a Rudraksha Mala. Once the eclipse is over, now this is an annular eclipse, so the effects would be there for 3 months. Now once this eclipse is over, for the next 3 months, here's what I want you to do. I want you to donate horse gram to the poor and needy. Take at least a fistful of horse gram should be donated. If you can donate more, great. And donate it as many times as possible. If you can do it daily, do it. Or if it's not possible, you can do it, say, every other day, once in a week, once a fortnight, whatever is comfortable for you, do it. Next, I want you to pray to Lord Ganesha. Again, Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha. Every day, recite it 108 times or multiples thereof. I want you to ensure that your southwest zone is free of any afflictions. It is very important, because if the southwest zone is afflicted, it will also mean that your wisdom is not working in its full capacity. So be careful there.